Hi guys, Ardawen here. So, today I did not went to one movie, I went to two movies. Yes, I went to a special night here in the local theater. Men's night that didn't show. That showed two movies, and that was The Bourne Legacy and Dead. Now they start with The Bourne Legacy, thank God. And I say this because, God damn it, it was an awful movie. It was probably the worst movie I've seen this year. First of all, I have to be honest, I didn't see the other three movies. Was it three movies? I think it was three movies. Still, I think when you make movies like that, which basically are stories are their own stories within a bigger story, you have to make something for the newcomer. And it was really, really confusing for me, who didn't see any of the other three movies, to get in this movie and get what the fuck was going on. I think I did get it eventually. But still. Another point was, in the trailers, they were kind of like, oh, there is this new guy, and this new guy is going to be a problem for the bad guys. However, there was hardly any of that new guy in it. I mean, there were, oh, it's only the tip of the iceberg. There is this other person, this other guy, and this other... And I know they showed more people, but the guy at the beginning of the movie, I was invested in that guy. I wanted to know what happened next to that guy after he discovered that his medicine that were in the snow were gone, and after he managed to kind of escape and disappear and stuff like that. So. Yeah, I really didn't like The Bourne Legacy, just like the ending. It was far too open, the ending. I mean, they're probably aiming for another sequel, and I understand that. But still, it's nah, it wasn't. It wasn't my kind of movie, you know. Do I have anything else to say about The Bourne Legacy? Not really. Sorry. Not really. Second was Dead, and oh my God, what a fucking hilarious movie. I mean, I was kind of afraid then that when I saw the trailer that those would be the best parts of the movies and of the movie, and me, and not only me, but everyone watching that with me pretty much left the entire movie. It was a fucking hilarious movie. Seth MacFarlane did a really, really fucking good job. So it's about, it already begins it's Christmas morning, and it's the evening before Christmas, you know, and all the Boston kids are doing what they're doing every day before Christmas, beating up the Jewish kids. And there was this really, that's how it starts, and that already sets the tone. And he starts with the racist kid, and he doesn't have a lot of friends, and he gets a teddy bear for his birthday, and, well, he wishes for his teddy bear to come alive, and he does, and they have this hilarious scene with his parents when he comes down in the kitchen to his parents, and his parents see Ted for the first time, they freak out, and then it's all over the news, and from Georgia, which is probably a religious state, I think, is, look what Jesus did, look what Jesus did, look what Jesus did, it was fucking hilarious. It was a really good movie. I really enjoyed it. So they grow up. So it's like, okay, they grow up with each other, and straight 27 years later, and the boy has a girlfriend, and the teddy bear is a typical washed up star. He's drugs. He doesn't have a job. He's leeching off his friends, and he's becoming a problem for the guy's relationship, and that's pretty much what the movie is about. It sounds like this basic story. It kind of is, you know. In the end, he kind of dies, and then he's back, and blah blah blah. Oh, did I say spoilers? God damn it! I forgot to say spoilers again. You know. Well, you know, he kind of guy dies because he's a sort of villain type of guy. And we're actually two villain type of guys, you know. The other interested in the girl, other guy interested in the girl, you know, or bloody bloody blah, the creepy guy and more creepy guy and his son. That his house filled with newspaper clippings of Dad, who really want to have Dad for his son, you know. And in the end, Dad dies, and then oh my god, they are both so sad, and the girlfriend realized that she was so wrong. The saying that Ted had to leave them with just the two of them, the girlfriend and the boyfriend, and then the girlfriend makes a wish, and yes, oh my god, that's hilarious. He comes back to life, and I say hilarious because I'm not going to explain too much. You really got to see Ted. It's really, really, when you're old enough to go see it, just go fucking see it, Dad. It's an amazing film. Which really brings me... On the other hand, I do have to say that I still can get a little bit angry that a movie like that, even though it's a really, really fucking good movie, gets in the theaters here in town, and Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunt. Some of you people must have seen me rant about it. They're just not showing it here in this town. It's fucking ridiculous. Why? Probably because it's Abraham Lincoln and it's American, and we're so nationalistic, anti-American fucks that we. Don't get me started again. So, yeah, that's my little chat about Abraham. There we go again, Abraham. That's my little chat about Ted and the Bourne Legacy. Definitely go and see Ted. When you're a fan of the whole Jason Bourne series, wait until it comes out on DVD and watch it on DVD. Because it's not worth your money to go see it in the movies. It's not. It's a fucking ridiculous film, and they should be ashamed to ask money for that. That's final. That's my final judgment about the Bourne Legacy. Trailers I saw. I only really watched the trailers at the beginning of the Bourne Legacy. I saw Dread, which I really want to see. I saw that movie that's going to be with Arnold Schwarzenegger. That is looking pretty bold. And I saw the new James Bond Skyfall trailer. And first off, this James Bond is not a good Bond, in my opinion. He, compared to the other James Bond, he's not what I think of when I think of James Bond. Second, it was just way too much action and explosions and stuff for a James Bond movie. I mean, James Bond is a different kind of movie. It's not that kind of movie. It doesn't mean that a movie with action and explosions and stuff like that is a bad movie. Not necessarily. I'm just saying that it isn't a James Bond movie, in my opinion. At least that much explosions and action and stuff like that. I mean, at least what a show in the trailer. It could be like the last 15 minutes that they show in the trailer. Could be, but still. What's also true is that the movies are about James Bond in the beginning. How Bond becomes Bond. However, the new M, the female M, is still in it. And I believe it's in GoldenEye. They picture this M in this, which is also in the newer films, which is supposed to be earlier on, as the new M. They make her the new M in the movies. They don't ignore the fact that there is suddenly a new M, that she is female. Nay, they make it a small point, but they do make it a point in, I believe it's GoldenEye. And now that female, that new female M is in the newer James Bond movies, which are supposed to be in an earlier part of Bond's life. And I know I'm a little bit nitpicky about it, but still. That was pretty much it. I do have to say that I liked the amount of people in the chair this man's night. They were a little bit noisy, but you know, probably a few men that were finally free of the girlfriend for one night, you know. So, do I have anything else to say? One thing, I have a Minecraft server now, World of Ada, and it's a public server, and you can play on it too. I will post the IP below and in the comment section, and you gotta have to check it out. It's a fun place to be with people, and yeah, I think I did a decent job building this Minecraft server. So there you go. You should really check it out. So that's it. I do not have anything else to say. It's 50 minutes past 2 here, so I'm going to bed, and I'm wishing you all a good night as well, and I see you all next time on an all new Ardawen Tries, because I got an envelope here. I will also shoot the Talk Like a Pirate Day episode, and next week it will be exactly a week from now, it will be one year since I filmed the very first Ardawen Tries about the Icky Beer. I need ideas, people. I need ideas. If you have any idea what I should do in a week, so you do have to know I can't ship things to you here within a week, so from the other side of the world, so it has to be something simple. But if you have something you should do that or you should do that, please tell me and I'll look at it. So that's it. Good night, everyone, and I see you all next time. Bye.